Well, look who it is. If it isn't our 2020 first-round pick, Cole Perfetti. How you doing, man?
I'm doing good. Thanks for having me on.
Look, man, you got your first taste of NHL action this year. I'm just wondering, do you feel like you had that first welcome to the NHL moment yet, or are you still waiting for it?
Yeah, there was a couple times on the trip where I was just like, wow, this is, I'm in the NHL now. This is pretty cool. But I think the biggest thing was, like, you know, when guys put money on the board before the game, and it was obviously the season opener for us. So there was quite a bit of money on the board, and I couldn't believe it. So, like, last year with the Moose, you know, we'd have like $500-$600 on the board, whatever it was. But with the Jets, I think we had close to like 40 or 45K on the board or something like that. So it was pretty cool. That was the moment I was like, this is showtime. This is pretty cool.
Wow, that is a lot of cash. Cole, if you don't mind just explaining to everyone what it means to have money on the board.
You know, whether it's like a meaningful game to them, you know, playing their old team, or they just signed a new contract, or for us, it was first game of the season. And, you know, say you put $1,000 or $500, whatever it is. If you guys win that night, that money will go to the out of your account to the team fund. And it's kind of just a way for guys to contribute to paying for team activities, and it allows the guys to do some pretty fun stuff together.
It's good to learn what money on the board means, because I think a lot of people who watch hockey didn't necessarily understand what it means to put money on the board. So, man, I want to talk about your first game for a moment. Everything that happened on the ice is one thing, but there's a bit of a story with your parents and how they ended up getting to your first game. Can you explain what happened?
They said they were coming. They were able to get their flights, you know, in the last minute. Them and the Drysdales pretty close. They have a good relationship. So they were able to, you know, book the same flight early the next day, the day of the game. And I think it was customs or no, it might have been security. I'm not sure. One of the two was crazy backed up. They weren't going to make the flight. The lines were just crazy. And they were like running to the flight. And luckily, Gary Drysdale stopped the plane and asked the pilot to wait, that my parents are going to be only a couple more minutes, and that they were flying out to see their son playing the first NHL game. So the pilot actually, you know, held the plane a couple minutes, and they were the last people on. Like, they closed the doors right behind them. And big shout out to them, the pilot and Gary. That was pretty cool.
Gary Drysdale with the primary assist, and the pilot with the secondary assist. That's awesome. So the World Juniors are around the corner. You know, especially at TSN, we love the World Juniors, and we love all the players that go. And, you know, you're going to be expected to be a leader there this year. I just want to ask, what is it like for you playing against your teammates in international competition?
You get close people, you play with them, and then, you know, you all of a sudden you're expected to play against them for your country, and it's a big difference. But once you know you're playing for Canada or whatever it is, I think, you know, friendships, relationships go to the side, and you just start playing. And I can't wait. I'm really looking forward to it. It's gonna be an amazing tournament, and I just can't wait to get it going.
And just looking at what the roster might be, you know, Shane Wright obviously is projected to go number one overall. Connor Bedard is projected to go number one. The year after that, he could make the team. And obviously, there's a bunch of players from last year who are coming back. So I am also very excited, not as excited as you because you're playing, obviously, but to watch. I don't remember the last time being this excited for a World Juniors tournament. My last question, Cole. The Jets have been rocking their Heritage Classic jerseys lately. And I just want to know, got a jersey right behind me here, what's your favorite Winnipeg Jets jersey of all time?
It's hard to find one that you don't like. I think they have some of the best unis in the league, between the colorway, the dark blue, the light blue, the white. Like, I think it just goes together so well. But my favorite is the aviator ones that say like Jets on it, the like baby blue. I think those are crisp. I like that color, and I think those ones might be my favorite, with the Heritage as a close second.
Look, Cole, thank you so much, man, for taking time to chat, and all the best, and keep up the good stuff, and can't wait to see you know, at the next level. I know it's coming soon, and the whole city's behind you, so all the best, man.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thanks for having me on. It was great talking to you today.
Of course. Thanks, dude.
Yep. Thank you.